So according to a recent National Health and Examination survey, L-carnitine is actually the third most popular supplement in America. Now, L-carnitine is especially popular in the bodybuilding and athletic community for its supposed ability to increase performance. However, it's also fairly popular in the alternative health community for its supposed ability to improve health parameters as well. And so essentially what I wanna do in this video is take a super deep dive into L-carnitine and talk about what it is, what it does in the body, and why I believe it to be such an important nutrient for overall health and performance. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, L-carnitine is an amino acid that can be synthesized by the body from the amino acids lysine and methionine. However, it is estimated that roughly 75% of the body's L-carnitine stores are a result of dietary intake, which is why it's so important to prioritize dietary intake. Now, L-carnitine isn't technically an essential amino acid because your body is able to produce it to some degree. However, it is considered a conditionally essential amino acid because of the fact that under certain circumstances, your body's not able to produce enough. And in these circumstances, supplementation is especially warranted and can be especially beneficial. Now, the primary role of L-carnitine in the body is to help transport fatty acids from the cytosol of the cell across the inner and outer mitochondrial membranes, where they can then be broken down into ATP for energy via beta oxidation. Now, ketosis gets a ton of attention these days for being a unique metabolic pathway by which fats can be broken down and utilized for energy. However, triglycerides can also be metabolized via lipolysis to produce fatty acids that can then be directly utilized by the mitochondria for energy production at a cellular level via the process of beta oxidation. However, in order for these fatty acids to enter the mitochondria, they first must cross the mitochondrial membrane, and this is where L-carnitine comes into play. L-carnitine acts as a shuttle that carries these fatty acids across the inner membrane and into the mitochondria so that they can then be metabolized and used for energy. Now, this metabolic pathway is formally known as beta oxidation and is a very specific type of aerobic respiration, which is a form of cellular respiration that your body uses pretty much like throughout the day as well as during low to moderate intensity exercise. Now, aerobic respiration can only happen in the presence of oxygen, which means that it can only occur when your respiratory system is able to supply the cells of your body with enough oxygen to carry out the cellular pathway. However, if you're doing some other activity that actually outpaces your body's ability to provide oxygen to the cells, that your body actually has to utilize a different metabolic pathway known as anaerobic respiration or the creatine phosphate system. However, what's interesting about L-carnitine is that even though it is exclusively utilized for beta oxidation to improve aerobic respiration, which is again in the presence of oxygen, it also appears to improve anaerobic and creatine phosphate cellular respiration as well, which actually brings us to our first possible health benefit of supplementing with L-carnitine, and that is benefits to athletic performance. However, before we get into the effects of L-carnitine on athletic performance, I do want to give a huge shout out to today's video sponsor, Element. Now, one of the most important and well-established factors that can improve athletic performance is hydration status. However, it is impossible to stay hydrated without adequate electrolyte intake, and this is what Element does so well. Element is a perfectly proportioned electrolyte mix that makes it extremely easy to help meet your electrolyte needs, especially during strenuous activity. And aside from the science behind Element's ability to help keep you hydrated, it also doesn't hurt that it tastes freaking amazing and also has zero sugars or fillers. And so if you're anything like me in trying to optimize and maintain proper physical performance and mental performance under somewhat extreme conditions, I can't more highly recommend Element. And right now they're offering my listeners a free sample pack of an 8 serving of Element for free with any order, but this deal is only available through the link in the description of this video. So make sure to go down and follow the link down below or go to drinkelement.com/nutritionlibrary to snag this offer. Now, because of its primary physiological role, L-carnitine is thought to primarily work by increasing energy output at a cellular level. And in this meta-analysis in particular, the researchers noted that, quote, L-carnitine plays an essential role in enhancing endurance and recovery from fatigue. The beneficial effects of both acute and chronic L-carnitine supplementation in several pathological conditions are well documented, such as infectious diseases, hemodialysis, cancer, and dystonia. Its intake has beneficial effects on healthy subjects too. In the elderly, it reduces fatigue sensation and improves physical, mental, and cognitive function, as well as reducing fatigue. In athletes, it facilitates the recovery process and increases blood flow and oxygen supply to muscle tissue. In addition, it alleviates muscle injury and reduces markers of cellular damage, decreasing free radical formation. Now, in this study in particular, the researchers were slightly more concerned with the effects of L-carnitine on specific clinical conditions. However, they did note that L-carnitine does appear to be a promising molecule to improve athletic performance in youth as well. And on this note, there are a handful of clinical trials that do show that L-carnitine can, in fact, improve athletic performance in young, healthy adults. And in one of these studies in particular, the researchers concluded that, quote, the results showed that the maximal exercise intensity treatment with L-carnitine significantly increased both maximal oxygen uptake and power output. Moreover, at similar exercise intensities in the L-carnitine trial, oxygen uptake, carbon dioxide production, pulmonary ventilation, and plasma lactate were reduced. It is concluded that under these experimental conditions, pretreatment with L-carnitine favored aerobic processes, resulting in more efficient performance. Now, it is worth noting that in this study in particular, the researchers did specifically note an improvement in aerobic performance, which again is low to moderate intensity exercise and is typically what we would consider cardio. However, what's interesting is that if you look at studies such as this one, the researchers concluded that, quote, there were significant increases in bench press lifting volume at week 6 and week 9 with L-carnitine supplementation, and a similar trend was observed with leg press. In the L-carnitine group at week 9, there were significant increases in mean power and peak power, reduction in post-exercise blood lactate levels, and beneficial changes to total antioxidant capacity. They concluded that L-carnitine supplementation enhances exercise performance while attenuating blood lactate and oxidative stress responses to resistance training. And so not only does L-carnitine appear to improve aerobic respiration like cardio, which is to be expected because of its primary physiological role in beta oxidation, but it also appears to fairly potently improve anaerobic respiration and performance as well. But the big question here is why, which is what brings us to this study where the researchers concluded that, in summary, this is the first study to demonstrate that muscle carnitine content can be increased in humans by dietary means, and perhaps more importantly, that carnitine plays a dual role in skeletal muscle fuel metabolism that is exercise intensity dependent. Specifically, we have shown that increasing muscle carnitine content spares muscle glycogen during low-intensity exercise, consistent with an increase in muscle lipid utilization, but during high-intensity exercise results in a better matching of glycolytic, PDC, and mitochondrial flux, thereby reducing muscle anaerobic ATP production. And so in layman's terms, what appears to be going on here is that L-carnitine is so potent at improving aerobic respiration at a cellular level that it's lowering the demands being placed on the anaerobic system to produce ATP. Now, the reason this is a good thing is that typically anaerobic respiration is considered more of a dirty cellular respiration because of the fact that it produces lactate as a byproduct. Now, when lactate builds up in muscle tissue, it increases the acidity of the muscle tissue and will eventually shut down contractibility of muscle tissue. However, this is not an issue with aerobic respiration and is the reason why you can kind of run at a slow pace for a long time. However, if you're doing like a max sprint or a max weightlifting set, there becomes a point where you just can't do anything further, and that happens very quickly because of the lactate that is produced via the anaerobic cellular pathway. And so what it looks like is happening is that L-carnitine is improving your body's ability to produce ATP via the aerobic respiration cellular pathway and thereby both increasing aerobic performance and anaerobic performance. Now, as a result of this, L-carnitine also appears to secondarily also be able to reduce exercise-induced inflammation, decrease exercise-induced muscle damage, lower exercise-induced oxidative stress, and decrease muscle soreness. And what's really cool about all of this is that not only does all of these effects lead to an increase in performance over time, but it also appears to lead to a decrease in fat mass over time, as well as an increase in the accumulation of muscle tissue over time. However, not only does L-carnitine appear to improve physical performance, but it also appears to improve cognitive performance as well. In one of the most remarkable studies that I came across doing research for this video, the researchers of this study in particular concluded that the pooled data across 9 randomized controlled trials showed that L-carnitine significantly reduced depressive symptoms. In 3 randomly controlled trials comparing L-carnitine versus antidepressants, L-carnitine demonstrated similar effectiveness compared to established antidepressants in reducing depressive symptoms. In these latter randomized controlled trials, the incidence of side effects was significantly lower in L-carnitine than the antidepressant group. Subgroup analysis suggested that L-carnitine was most efficacious in older adults. L-carnitine supplementation significantly decreases depressive symptoms compared to placebo/no intervention, whilst offering a comparable effect to established antidepressant agents with fewer side effects. And as alluded to in this paper, L-carnitine appears to be especially beneficial for the population that is dealing with age-related cognitive issues, and has been confirmed in a handful of other trials that have looked into the effects of L-carnitine on Alzheimer's disease as well as generalized cognitive decline, and have also found positive effects. However, the cognitive benefits of supplementing with L-carnitine don't appear to be just specific to the aging population. There are also a handful of clinical trials that have shown some benefit of L-carnitine supplementation in youth dealing with symptoms of ADHD as well. Now, the mechanisms of action here appear to be 2 primary factors. The first one being L-carnitine's ability to just in general improve ATP production at a cellular level, and thereby allow the neural cells in particular to be more efficient at producing energy, which is going to produce improvements in cognitive function. And the second mechanism of action here appears to be that L-carnitine can increase the level of some specific neurotransmitters in some specific brain regions that are responsible for memory, attention, and cognition. Now, specifically, L-carnitine has been shown to increase levels of serotonin, GABA, and adrenaline, and low levels of these hormones have been linked to cognitive issues and mood issues. And so by L-carnitine being able to at least maintain the level of these neurotransmitters in key brain regions, it does appear to be able to improve, again, both attention, memory, and mood. Now, the last possible benefit that I want to take a deep dive into in this video, aside from its ability to improve physical performance and cognitive performance, is its ability to improve testicular function in men. Now, there is little to absolutely no evidence that L-carnitine can increase testosterone, unfortunately. However, there is some evidence to suggest that it can maintain testosterone in instances of stress. However, unfortunately, even in men that are experiencing age-related drops in testosterone, L-carnitine still doesn't appear to improve testosterone levels, even though it does appear to improve mood, fatigue, and sexual dysfunction associated with low testosterone. Now, where L-carnitine appears to really shine is that it appears to be extremely potent at improving fertility markers. And as it turns out, L-carnitine is actually the most well-researched and most consistent compound that has ever been researched, at least it's natural, that has been shown to improve several different markers of fertility, making it one of the best go-to options for any guy that's out there that's looking to improve fertility for the purposes of conceiving. Now, aside from L-carnitine's ability to maintain testosterone levels in the face of stress, as well as improve fertility markers, it also appears to, interestingly enough, increase the level and the density of androgen receptors on muscle tissue. And so even though it doesn't increase testosterone per se, it does appear to increase the responsiveness to testosterone, which means that this might actually be one of the mechanisms by which it actually improves physical performance as well as recovery recovery and muscle retention and fat burning. Now, aside from its benefits to physical performance, cognitive performance, as well as testicular function, it also appears to be fairly potent at improving markers of liver function, blood pressure, blood glucose control, blood lipids, oxidative stress, and inflammation as well, which is why, in my opinion, L-carnitine is not just a fantastic and promising option to improve performance, but also just general health and well-being as well. But other than that, guys, that's pretty much all I have for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below, and make sure to check out the description down below for a link to snag your free sample of Element. But other than that, I think I'll see you guys next time.